And now you'll see my favorite. And the one I typically focus on upgrading first. Because you can play more defensively with Collect. The game plays a bit more like classic Geometry Wars with Collect. So you don't have to put yourself in harm's way to collect the gems nearly as much. Magnet works just like the Collect drone does. Sometimes you have to, you know? Things get a little crazy. We'll set some mines here. Now, of course, your ship is still magnetizing geomes while you're playing. It's just having a second one there collects the further away geomes while you're moving out of harm's way. It's a pretty decent strategy, one I enjoy very much. Now when the music fluctuates like that, I'm setting more mines. We now have red barriers. Great. Of course, those kill you and you cannot break them. They block your shots. So we've almost collected 1,000 geomes already. And you see where Collect comes in handy. There's silver. I'm okay with that. That was almost my high score. Impressive. Now this. Basically how this works is whenever you clear a gate, it explodes, and any enemies that are in the blast radius also get destroyed. And of course the gates are moving around, so you have to navigate that shift while avoiding enemies. Admittedly, this is not my favorite game mode. Although this is just a tutorial for it, so the gold ones are pretty big boost to your score. But it's not worth dying for. I tend to only play those once. Admittedly, not my favorite. King mode. Let's try attack, shall we? So as it just said, you can only attack in these little barriers, which clear in a second or two. And you have to collect the geomes and go back to your barrier. And you're more or less defenseless outside of your barrier. Maybe the mimes will do some work. Yep. Where is it? There it is. It's like couldn't quite clear them in time. The patterns disappear if you take too long. Can't let it always disappear. Oh boy. Guess we didn't have smart bombs. Oops. Oh well. Still pretty close to my record. I'm okay with that. Cubism. So there are two fail states here. One of which is having the whole grid change colors. The other is, of course, dying. So, what you do is you try to find where the painters are and clear them as soon as you can. But in a 3D environment, it's harder to do. Where is it? There it is. Because gradually it's going to be moving around the field, and as it does, of course it's going to be coloring the field. Where is it? Here it is. Now we can do better than that. Come on now. So we have a smart bomb, do we? Smart bomb and a super. I like how the drones look different based on the one that you've chosen. It's kind of cute. No you don't, buddy. You still have to watch out yourself. And that's why I'm constantly moving around and trying to dodge. It's pretty self-explanatory, but the number in the middle, that's how many squares are left before you lose. You can't defend one general area because whenever a new paintbrush appears, it turns a few squares, well, it paints a few squares just like that. So the only thing you can do is kill them as quickly as you can and hope they spawn in an area that's already painted. Which, as you play, happens more and more often, of course. This isn't working too terribly well. Is this strategy maybe attack mode? It seems like every time we get the super state, it's magnet here. What is the approach? Good thing the music is so relaxing. Where is it? There it is. Then again, we're just doing that for the multiplier, so we got close, didn't we? We got close. Perhaps the problem is we're moving around too much. That could certainly be. Even the areas you cannot see are being painted, though. Oh, hello, Super State. Missiles. Great. Homing missiles should help deal with some of the painters. Collect is shifting over to the side there to pick up those geomes. We can focus more on survival. I didn't realize we had two bombs. Now I do. That may come in handy. I was about to say, waiting for that super state to appear. So, Not only could we get that super state, but that's also a pretty decent boost to your geomes. Split fire again, huh? You've lived long enough, is what the game is telling you. It's time to move on. And move on we do. Now, you do not have to use a particular geome to quote-unquote level it up. It's based on the amount of geomes you have total. Which is both a good thing and a bad thing. Good thing because there are some geomes I don't use as often as others. Bad news because each one has to be leveled up separately. And there are some maps that are better with some drones than others. This game mode is pretty self-explanatory. If there are too many enemies on one side, when you flip over to deal with them, they'll overwhelm you. So you have to keep flipping back and forth. And deal with the threats as they come along. Especially if there's a super state on one of the sides. Now we're talking. Oops, wrong side. Come on, flip over. There we go. So you do the best you can on one side, flip over to the other. Rinse and repeat. Super state over here, with all the snakes. Now we're talking. Not sure how many lives we have. I think we just have until the time runs out. Not that I'm about to die and find out, though. It's over here. Okay. You do not get any more smart bombs or missiles as you put supers or smart bombs as you play. So that's when it quickly becomes all about survival. Okay. Confirmed, lives are not a problem. Got a little greedy there with the super state. Ah, so close. If we didn't die, we would have made it. Oh well. Onwards and upwards. Evolved. So we only have one life. Collected miner it is. So one of the things I do enjoy about this game is this constantly shifting battleground. Yeah, we can do better than that. Come on. I mean, we could switch to the more aggressive attack, but then we'd be putting ourselves in more danger trying to collect the geomes. So it's a toss-up, you know? That's one thing you are going to learn, is I'm not going to use my smart bombs hardly ever. Even though I definitely should. Because as I was saying before, in the original Geometry Wars and Galaxies, as your multiplier resets every time you die, I tended to save them until my very last life, and then die before I use them. We're getting there. We're getting there. That dude was aggressive, wasn't it? Alright, we'll try this one more time, and if it doesn't work, we'll switch back over to attack. I think we can level it up again, don't you? We probably have 3,000 by now. attack works better against the green and pink friends that we have. I'll collect. Lets you focus on one hitbox, and that's your own. So you don't have to worry about the hitboxes of the Geomes. Set some mines on the field, shall we? Yeah. Now those really tiny yellow dudes are very dangerous just because of their size. Just because of their size. There's bronze. Bronze is enough for now. Well, we're not using mine anymore. And what a perfect time to get a new one as well. So we had 16 million here before, so probably another Titan mode. Maybe. We'll see. Nope. Each level and collect is a pretty beefy benefit. And that's another benefit of collect. While you're collecting on one side, you can start firing on the other to make sure that you're constantly moving and out of the way of the enemies. Trying here to save our smart bomb for when we'll really need it. We survived. Now we're talking. Of course, certain strategies for some enemies don't work quite as well in others, naturally. Absolutely not. I see what you're trying to do. You stay back. Mock fire again, huh? I see why. Phew! It's classic fun, huh? Spawn mode. Destroy the spawners before they overwhelm you. So where are you? There you are. You can't actually destroy them until they fire. That was way too early. What can you do though, right? Missiles will be good here. Speaking of, eesh, it's getting kind of dangerous here. Is this a shield? Come on, we can do better than that. I honestly do think attack is better here. Deal with the arrows. Deal with the spawner. Deal with the arrows. Deal with the spawner. Deal with the arrows. That was primarily to save the super state. Yes, it is shield. Each pattern has its own state. That was very clearly shield. Alright, time for some cleanup duty.
Phew.
Infected. This one's fun. It's time to flip back over to attack though. So the long short of it is, these little green things don't give you any geomes, but you have to destroy them to get to the yellow sections, which do. All the while, the virus itself is multiplying, which again, isn't doing much for your multiplier, but it helps tremendously with score. This level's claustrophobia defined. Nice. Trying to keep the infection from spreading too much. You don't get quite as much of a multiplier here, but your score boosts pretty tremendously just by the multiplying itself. The only danger is safely getting to the multiplier. Split fire helps. It's just going to continue multiplying here. I was just waiting for a super state to get another huge boost in score. Ooh, a little too close for comfort there. Ah! Let's do one more tonight, shall we? Not quite enough to level up attack, but we'll see how we do. Once again, I'm not the biggest fan of 3D battle environments like these. Oh, hello. Are there two now? How could there be two? So the gimmick of this particular boss is you have to defeat the clone before you can damage the original. And there's another clone, of course. Hello, clone. Is there another clone? Yeesh. It's pretty intense. Pretty intense. We can handle it though, right? We have an attack drone. Attack drone will keep us safe. Citation needed. Kill the clone as quickly as we can so it doesn't keep spawning enemies. And turn our attention to the main event. I'm starting to move around a little bit now. Have another clone to deal with. Yeesh. Yeesh. Kind of rough. But there's no question, firepower's what's really needed here. course, the nice thing is, even if we're losing, we're grinding in a way, because we're continuing to get geomes. So there's improvement even in failure. Not that you want failure, of course. But you can't win them all right away. Can you? I don't think so. There's one. There's two. Is there a third one? Where would it be? There it is. Now we can fire on the core. There we go. Of course, getting angry. I have to push our way back so we can take out the core as soon as possible. Deal with the snakes. Push forward a little bit. Kind of baited towards us. Final wave. Those are dangerous. We got this, though. We got this. Let's think about all of the geomes we've earned. Dealing with the arrows. Damage control. Focus on a clone. Clone defeated. Keep our green friends out of the way. It's a good thing these time limits are quite generous. Probably not doing the best when it comes to clock control, though. That was like a black hole, wasn't it? Yeesh, stop that. We don't need any more arrows. Go away. You too. And you. Running out of time here. Taking way too long on this phase. That's a little better, time-wise. Same as before, deal with the arrows, deal with the snakes, push up. Deal with the snakes, push up. Deal with the snakes. Push up. There we go. Snakes seem like a pretty big boost to your score. And this, my arcade friends, is why you level up your geomes. And drones, by using geomes, that is. Whew. It's taking a little longer than anticipated. We'll get through it, though. I have faith in us. Wait, did that? Yeah, seemed like that did clear the arrows that were close to it. Good to know. We're learning. Too bad I didn't clear those. Where are you? There you are. Still not moving around much yet. There we go. Two down. wait for you spawn, wait for you to spawn your dudes. It's a lot to take in at once, trying to find the direction the arrows are going, while at the same time keeping the targets sighted and pointed at. But we made it. The Super State should be next, I think. Perhaps not. Nope, there it is. Alright. Slowly but surely. Probably just focus on a boss while we have the Super State. Yeah, that's the strategy. Okay. That's what you do. Still pretty manageable. Oh no! I don't have any smart bombs left. Whew. Not necessary. And I think that's a good place to stop for tonight. Thanks for joining us here at the Arcade Lodge. I'll see you next time.